The pace of it, Sanjay, relates so much more to the technological advances of the platform technologies that are being used right now. If you look back, go back a few years to SARS, we developed a vaccine for SARS. We used the DNA platform. We never had to use it because SARS disappeared back in 2002. From the time we got the sequence to the time we went into a phase one trial was 20 months. Because of a familiarity with the platform technology, from the time we got the sequence from the Chinese on January 10th to the time we started making the vaccine was 5 days. From the time then to the time we went into phase one was 62 days. So we truncated a lot of time, had nothing to do with safety. We haven't even gone near a person yet. It was only the technological advances. And right now the FDA is not cutting corners, but they're doing things in a much more rapid, expedited way. Another way we're saving time is that we're making investments where the risk, you know, we always say we're proceeding at risk. That's also a bad terminology because people think you're proceeding at a risk to me. No, we're proceeding at a risk to the money because we're essentially preparing sites and even manufacturing vaccine before you know it works. So the good news is that if it works, you've saved many months. If it doesn't work, you've lost a lot of money. But we think, when they say you, I mean the federal government has lost a lot of money. And what happens then is that there's no risk to the integrity of the study and no risk to the safety of the study. That has allowed us to go into a phase three trial in at least a couple of candidates in the month of July, which would have been unheard of a decade ago. And that's the reason why when we talk about how long it takes. So let's take one of the vaccines. Mm. And we have no idea, Sanjay, whether one is better than the other right now. There may be some that are temporally ahead of the others, but the proof of the pudding is the need to do a randomized placebo-controlled trial. So right now, it's a prime and a boost. So we started injecting last week. 28 days, you get the boost. It's going to take about 3 months to get everybody enrolled, which will bring you into the fall. By the time you get a signal, my projection, which is only a projection, is that somewhere towards the end of the year, the beginning of 2021, we will know whether we have a safe and effective vaccine. I'm cautiously optimistic that we will be successful because when you look at the phase one data, it induces a level of antibody in that relatively small number of people, but it's clear the results that are at a level of antibody neutralizing that is comparable to, if not better, than convalescent plasma from someone who's recovered. And one of the tenets of vaccinology is that if your vaccine induces a response that's at least equivalent to natural infection, you don't have a guarantee, but that's a pretty good predictor of success. So although we never guarantee success, I feel cautiously optimistic we'll have that. So that's a relatively short period of time from January around to maybe December, January. And if you recall, I said on your show when you asked me, when do you think you'll have a vaccine? You asked me in January. I said about a year from now. Yeah. So if we do it, then we will have accomplished that goal.